Hey guys, MZ here. Welcome back again to Danganronpa. Now, last episode, I'm still so severely bummed out. Somebody went and killed Chihiro. First Sayaka, now Chihiro. Who's next? What are they gonna do? Are they gonna kill Sakura or Taka or... Okay, Taka's kind of annoying, especially with him and Mondo going the whole bro route, but come on. This guy's the one that needs to be frickin' wiped out. So irritating. Anyways, we're in the middle of the, we're in the middle of the investigation, we're trying to figure things out, and, oh, that's right, we're supposed to be leaving. Oh, you just said to freaking leave. I remember, on the other side of this door, isn't this the door out? Oh, no, it's the archive. Okay, I don't remember them talking about the archive before, but whatever, you know, probably passed over it at some point. Hurry up and go inside. Here? It'll all make sense once you're inside. Oh, yay. I do not like Byakuya. Yeah, I know, I'm a freaking broken record, and I apologize for that, but I cannot stand Byakuya. Personality issues, I think. Anyways, oh, so many books and files. And so much dust. Yeah, right? I mean, come on. Couldn't have a Monokuma running around cleaning stuff up, keeping stuff looking nice, seriously? I would say there's enough value in this place to endure the dust. Yeah, but it's still dusty, so... Ew. What do we got going on here? Alright, we got three spots, or six, five spots. There's a wooden box, it's empty. Although, judging by the smudges in the dust, it looks like there was something inside. Yeah, that looks like a... I don't know, coil of something, or... I wonder what it was. Oh, there was an extension cord plug in there. It proved very useful while I was in the library. Oh, that's right, because he used to plug his little reading lamp into it. Extension cord, huh? Curiouser and curiouser. It's a desk lamp. Yeah, that's the one he used, and there's the extension cord right there. Oh, wrong one. It's the same one I saw Byakuya using in the library before. You have a problem with that lamp? No. Oh, there it is. That's the button I was looking for. Sorry, guys. I don't usually bother moving the text box, so the one time I really wanted to, I clicked the wrong button. Never fails. Do you have a problem with that lamp? It was here before, then I moved it over there. It's too dark over there, so I thought I'd put it to good use. Yay. I don't care what you do with a frickin' desk lamp, dude. What I do have a problem with is... Somebody killed Chihiro. Shelf is stuffed tight with files. Without really thinking about it, I pick one at random. Ah, you have a sharp eye indeed to select that file. I just sort of grabbed it, took a look. Huh? That's the report on a presidential assassination. The original is kept at the National Library. It won't be declassified for another 30 years. Are you sure you want to look at it now? There's no telling whose crosshairs you might wind up in for peeking at it. We're locked in a school, dude. I mean, are you going to execute me for it? Seriously? Makoto, without making a sound, I return the file to the shelf. Should have taken a peek, man. There's so many files stuffed onto the shelf. What's in all these things? Those documents are dangerous. Dangerous? They detail all the people who control the world from behind the scenes. Dangerous truths for a commoner. Hey, you're just as common as me in here, dude. You mean like members of the Diet or something? What? The Diet. No, I mean the ones with real power, the secret council controlling everything from the shadows. Oh, you're one of those people. If you're ready to be disappeared for it, take a look. There are some very interesting people in there. Wow. Great English, bro. You're just kidding, right? Am I? I'll just let it go for now. You know, he claims to be just some high uppity up, and he uses such bad language. Get out of the way, Bayaki. I want to see the thing behind you. A ton of thick files stuffed down in the bookshelf. If you're thinking of looking through any of them, let me give you a little warning. Those things are filled with graphic, disturbing photos from all kinds of crime scenes. It's the kind of thing any normal person wouldn't ever want to look at. Be careful. What do you mean? All those files there are investigation reports related to different cold cases. Those are internal documents for police eyes only. They're not the kind of thing you'd expect to leak. So, are you finally beginning to understand the true splendor of this library? It's got a lot of information in it. The entire reason I was interested in the library is because of this room right here. It's home. It's home to classified government documents, police records, things no ordinary person would ever see. Isn't it magnificent? I've seen the Grand Library, dude. This little rinkadink closet isn't much. This can't be for real, right? That's your guy's problem. Anything that doesn't fit into your preconceived reality, you label it as a lie. Well, it's not that. It's not like I totally refuse to believe it, but, I mean, there's just so much. How could anyone have put all this together? I suppose it goes to show how much power Hope Speak truly wields. Or perhaps the mastermind may have wanted to provide us with enough entertainment to keep us from getting bored. It's no use. I can't keep up with all this. It's just too unreal. What's wrong? You still can't believe it? What about you? How can you believe it so easily? Things like that are usually impossible. What do you mean, usually? Usually, normal, ordinary, or simple. These things don't exist anywhere in the real world. I'm gonna disagree with you. If you don't understand what they actually represent, you don't understand the nature of anything. You don't pull punches, do you? No, he just... he's one of those people that if it doesn't follow what he thinks is right, then it must be wrong, and anyone that doesn't see it his way is an idiot, or can't understand the quote-unquote higher things that he can. People like him, I just do not get along with. Besides, what you consider usual is based on your common sense, right? But what makes you think your own common sense applies to me at all? The documents gathered here are genuine. I have reviewed them multiple times, so there's no doubt. Hold on a sec. You're saying you've read all these documents, and more than once. But all this has to be, like, top-secret confidential stuff, right? So how... My family has a reading room just like this at our home. Ours is bigger, of course, and not as dusty. So... Huh? Members of the Togami family have access to any variety of government-related documents. That includes foreign powers as well as domestic. Oh! Excuse me. So you're like a dignitary or something, right? If it was a simple business, they wouldn't allow you to have that sort of thing. How is that possible? I already told you, there's a secret council that controls the world from the shadows. My family is a member of that council. Yeah, sure. And I have within me the bloodline that will allow me to one day bend the world to my will. Anyways. But to become such a ruler, I must know all levels of this world backwards and forwards. so whenever I have the time, I like to review whatever documents and materials that interest me. Which is why I can proclaim without a doubt that the material gathered here are the real thing. Yeah, this is beyond believing or not believing. Byakuya is actually starting to scare me more than the actual mastermind. Well, yeah, to think a little twat like him might run the world? Yeah, that would, I think it would scare anybody. And what always interested me the most were the cold case police investigation reports. Reading through those reports has always been a hobby of mine ever since I was little. I can imagine that. Little Byakuya, about, 4 or 5 years old, sitting on the bed. Mommy, read me a story. Okay, darling. Well, you see, this is a cold case file. Where, somebody had their arms and legs ripped off, and they were strung up from the rafters, and that's how their little children found them. Oh, yay, I haven't heard that one yet, Mommy. I mean, what the hell? I knew this game was kind of sick and twisted and jacked up when I started playing it, but holy damn. I'm sorry. I'm spending all this time poking fun at him, and I'm not moving the game along. Sorry, guys. It's excellent mental exercise. I've solved more than a few of those cases just by reviewing the reports. And among all those reports, one of my recent favorites is the Genocide Jack case. As he talked, Byakuya grabbed a specific file from the shelf. This is the complete case file. Every single report surrounding the Genocide Jack case has been compiled in here. Because there are so many, allow me to quickly summarize the main points. To begin, there are two notable characteristics in every Genocide Jack murder. The first characteristic is that every crime scene, the word bloodlust is written in the victim's own blood. And the second is that when the victims are murdered, their bodies are suspended in a certain way. Bloodlust is written in blood and the victim's body is suspended. It's exactly the same as what happened to Chihiro. Save your surprise, the best part is yet to come. For the second characteristic, where the victims are suspended, the only ones who knew about that particular fact were members of the police and other higher-ups. Okay, so only higher-up people knew how they were suspended, or that they were suspended? By all accounts, nobody in the media ever found out. In other words, no one on the news, nor no one online, nobody knew about that aspect of each crime. Only key officials and the killer himself knew about this act of mounting the victim. Now, if you recall Chihiro's corpse, her body was most certainly mounted in this fashion. So, how could the killer have known about suspending the victim? That's the key question. But in fact, the answer is quite simple. The culprit isn't a copycat killer. It's the real Genocide Jack. That's right. There's the evidence that Genocide Jack has hidden himself among the rest of us. Okay, if this is a school for ultimates, as twisted as it sounds, the ultimate serial killer would most likely get invited. Although, why wait till now to bother? I mean, could have started from the beginning, slim the numbers right off the bat. Then Genocide Jack really is such a brutal fiendish killer, or such a brutal fiendish killer really is walking around among us. I read that really weird, sorry about that. Things are really starting to get interesting, aren't they? I never imagined a killer with such a reputation would ever become part of our little game. Now, don't you think it would be good for you to take a look at what I've already seen? You might just manage to ferret out a clue or two. If you get down on your knees and beg, I might even show you myself. How about I take that lamp and remove your knees? That sounds like a whole lot better idea. Nope, just saying. Nope, we're gonna check out. Not interested. We still have more to check. Oh, you're gonna make me check. Yeah. All those files, our investigation reports. Yep, those are internal documents. All right. We already read this part. I actually have to talk to you. Byakuya, about that Genocide Jack case file, could you let me see it?
That's fine.
Well, you didn't beg, but I guess it's okay this time. I wouldn't beg, dude. Not gonna happen. Feel free to look at it in here, but you can't take it with you. Byakuya handed me the file and I flipped through it with tense, nervous fingers. Suddenly, my hand stopped. I'd reached the page where photos from the scene of each crime had all been collected. I like how the music got all, heavy. Alright, we're gonna turn that back down. That's a little loud in my ears. Anyways. I do like how the music just got all heavy like that, so that was pretty freaking sweet. Sorry, I probably should have warned you guys I was gonna, turn it up, but my bad. I'll try and remember to do that in the future. Anyways, what do we have here? Let us see. Wait a second. All these people have been killed by scissors. And what, 1, 2, 3, 4? There are 4 of them? And they were stabbed to death with scissors. And then suspended with said scissors. Chihiro was tied up with a frickin' extension cord. No, that's a copycat. Whoever it is, they don't have access to those scissors. At least, I don't think they do. God, that one dude has it, right in the top of his head. Ugh. The names of Genocide Jack's victims ran on for several pages. Ken Harada, 32. Tetsuhiro Honda, 17. Shoji Gaku, 23. Kanoise, 14. Takeshi Yoshida, 30. They're all guys, too. Takeshi Masamune. There's no end to it, but one thing became perfectly clear as I read. All of the killer's countless victims were killed and suspended in exactly the same way. And at the scene of every murder, the word bloodlust was left in the victim's own blood. Yeah, but Chihiro was hung up with a set of scissors, not a freaking, not a freaking extension cord. So, she might have been suspended, but she wasn't suspended in the same manner. Now take a look at the next page, and you'll find another interesting tidbit. The next page. I love this music. I mean, I know it's supposed to be tense and, pushing you to go on, but I could handle this as just a single. Throw it on my phone or iPod or something. Profiling results. All of the crimes took place either on weekdays... What kind of play? Either on weekdays at night or during holidays, either day or night. The most common time for the killing to take place was on holidays in the afternoon. So this was a... Based on these facts, it could be suggested that the suspect may be a student. Evidence suggests that the suspect lingered at the scene, but when they did leave, they were in a panic. So, we're looking at somebody who wanted to see what was going on, but then when the police showed up, they ran away scared? Because an eyewitness has never come forward, it's unlikely there was any external reason for this. This confused behavior suggests that the suspect may potentially suffer from dissociative identity disorder. The key point here is that the culprit may well have a split personality. Split personality? Like the kind of thing you see on TV? So I'm part of another totally unbelievable story. Yeah, right? Not to mention the science behind that one's a little, we're not going to get into it. That's a different can of worms. But this one is way more unbelievable than anything else up till now. Or maybe it really isn't. I don't know. I feel like my mind is going numb. Well, at least we got the murder cases of Genocide Jack. It's added to our truth bullet section of our handbook. Alright, we should get going soon. Where are we going? Anywhere but here. We finished our business here. Haven't we? Wait, Byakuya. I don't know. As usual, Byakuya turned and left without another word. I hurried out of the library to catch up. This is where we part ways. I have some things I need to take care of before the class trial. What? Okay, first off, you basically dragged me along with you, and now you're saying, I've shown you this, so now we're going to walk away. It's all of a sudden like that? Come on, enough of your annoying misapprehensions. Did you really think we'd be together the whole time? Take responsibility for yourself and do something useful. Move the investigation forward on your own. Well, goodbye. And just like that, he was gone. Just as quickly as he asked me to join him, he cut me off. In the end, I felt like I was just some plaything getting tossed around. Yeah, right? At the same time, I've uncovered some really important clues thanks to him. Genocide Jack, he's the one that killed Chihiro. And that murderous fiend is one of us. But who is it? I have to find that out no matter what it takes. And to do that, there's somewhere I have to go investigate one more time. I have to go back to the crime scene, the girls' locker room. I should check the boys' locker room, too. And the others might have come up with some info I might find useful while I'm at it. I need to find out everything I can. Yeah, very true. If I can remember where the heck I am. Alright. Yeah, because it seemed like he was leading us, like, he was trying to usher us out. Like, he's already got his own preconceived ideas of what's going on, and he just kind of wanted to push us along on his own agenda. Alright. See, now, the first thing that bothered me about as soon as I showed up to the murder scene, the first thing that bothered me was the frickin' photos, or the wallpaper, or whatever the heck, poster, that's the word, yeah, I speak good. Because if I remember right, when I first came and looked at this place, there was that girl poster in here. And now we've got this guy poster in here. I don't understand. It's a popular boy band called Tornado. Somehow it doesn't quite seem to fit with the boys' locker room. Yeah, right? The cute girl from the other locker room seems like she belongs on the wall. Huh. What's that? There's a strange stain on the carpet. What is it? Boys' locker room carpet's been added to the truth bullet section. Alright. I think that's it. Alright, so we got a little bit of an idea. Anything in here? I don't think there's gonna be anything in here. Nope, just moving along the, Alright, yep, leave the pool. And we'll have to head back out. saw Hifumi there. I didn't really want to talk to him, but I suppose we'll talk to him for a minute. Ding, Hifumi has discovered evidence revealing the identity of the culprit. Another stat increase for me. Evidence? What did you find? Sorry guys, I honestly completely forgot what kind of voice I even gave him, so there are so many people to keep track of. I'm just gonna read the lines. I might play with the voice a little bit, but probably not like I did before. I cannot reveal that just yet.
That's it. I'm sure of it.
But I guarantee that what I found will steal the killer's breath from his lungs. Are you sure about that? Oh yeah, Miss Ludenberg said she witnessed something worthwhile too. Miss Ludenberg. Oh, Celeste. Really? What did she see? She refused to tell me, but it's like when a girl bullies the boy she likes, right? Right? Oh, so you think she's a tsundere? She's not. She's just kind of a bitch at times. Okay, so where's Celeste now? The warehouse by the dorms. She was there, but at the same time, not there. So, which... Damn it, Hifumi. Which is it? Is she there or not there? Exactly. What's it gonna be? Like, frickin' get your story straight, dude. Alright. And the... He's, like, hidden. That's funny. Anyways. The biggest thing that bothers me here is, A, the girl poster. I can't imagine anyone putting the girl poster in a girl's locker room. And second of all, Mondo. Mondo said, dude. And it seemed like he was referring to Chihiro. That kind of bothers me. Like, if Chihiro's actually a dude, so what? Crossdresser. Who cares? But at the same time, knowing Mondo, I don't know how well he would handle that. Anyways, Kyoko, you got anything for us? Kyoko, have you made any progress on your investigation? Generally speaking. But I have to get going. I have something unrelated to take care of.
Oh, great. You're going to pull a Byaki and run off. Something besides the investigation? What is it?
Nothing you need to worry about. Just concentrate on the murder.
Yeah, right. But,
Before I go, let me give you one piece of advice. You should examine Chihiro's body one more time, thoroughly.
Oh. Also, her handbook is missing. Oh, sorry, it's Kyoko still.
Also, her handbook is missing. You might want to determine its whereabouts.
Her handbook? Why?
That is, I'll be praying for your success.
Well, thank you. For that, Kyoko turned and left the girl's locker room. I guess I'll take another look at the body, then. Yeah, her handbook is missing? What? What does that have to do with anything? Why is it worth worrying about? Curious now.
Alright. The blood is the most noteworthy part, but the big-breasted swimsuit model is pretty noticeable, too.
Yeah, exactly. Why would that be in here?
Girl's locker room doesn't seem like the kind of place you'd find something like this. But wait, that reminds me. The poster in the other locker room,
That's right. There's definitely something strange about this. In the boys' locker room, there's a poster of a popular boy band. In the girls' locker room, there's a poster of a big-breasted swimsuit model. Could the posters have been switched? What if they were? Why? What reason would anyone have?
Maybe I should talk to someone who knows a little more about the locker rooms.
The dogs keep growling over in the... laying on the bed. Keeps distracting me. Sorry.
Let's see. Yeah, the two has been added to the truth bullets. Alright.
not Mondo. I don't believe Mondo would know too much. It could only be caused by Chihiro's murder. Sakura! You spend a lot of time exercising in the girls' locker room, right, Sakura?
Of course.
I've used it nearly every day since it opened up. Sometimes Hina and I use it together. Okay, then let me ask you something. Do you think the poster in the boys' and girls' locker rooms could have been switched?
I'm sorry,
I can't really say. I've never really paid any attention to the posters. Well, dang it. I see. But there is something that's been bothering me about the locker room. You see, I like to drink a little protein coffee every time I finish exercising. Protein coffee. So you get the little pep in your step and you get the rebuild to your muscles, I guess? Sounds like it tastes horrible. We have protein coffee? Yeah, right? I like coffee and I don't mind certain flavors of protein powder, but together? Just, yeah. In the warehouse, it's not the highest quality, but I don't have a lot of other options. I mix the protein powder with coffee and down a glass of it after exercising. Anyway, the other day, I spilled some on the carpet in the girls' locker room, and it left a stain.
A stain?
But I don't see any stain on the carpet now.
Of course.
Exactly. I noticed it earlier. The stain has disappeared.
Oh. Wait a second. There's a stain on the boys' locker room carpet.
I can only assume someone came along and cleaned it up. But still, isn't it unusually clean, as if there was never a stain here to begin with?
Well, yeah, there's no stain here, but there's a stain in the boys' locker room, which means we gotta switcheroo.
Disappearing stain has been added. You got anything else to say, Mondo, or you just... Dude had a real complex about being weak.
I'm gonna go out on a limb and say that Chihiro was a dude, and not a dudette. Had a real complex about being weak. You heard Chihiro talk about it, right? Oh, I need to get stronger. Remember, she said that more than once. Sure did, which I guess would explain the trip down here, but did she really need to get stronger that badly? And you know, I'm gonna really disagree with that statement right there. Most girls aren't all that strong. I'm gonna disagree. I know way more girls that can kick a dude's ass than the other, than that are weak or unable to do things.
But why? I don't care about where the complex came from. He said, dude, Chihiro referenced themselves as her, I think, if I remember right. Maybe? Now I'm confused. I'm rather curious. But we have to... I don't want to examine a dead body. I know she said thoroughly, but I do have my limits. Well, Sakura's standing right there. You can have her check the body for you. Better give it a shot. Let's see. Chihiro's hands are bound with what looks like some kind of rope. The rope was used to prop her up in a kind of crucifix position. Huh? The rope has a plug? Yeah, that's not rope, dude. That's an extension cord. This isn't a rope at all. But the more I think about it, the more that's not the only thing that concerns me. Chihiro's fatal injury was the blow to the head, which means someone struck her in the head in order to kill her. That's right. There's the issue of her being suspended and the fatal blow. First, I didn't see any reason to think too much about either of them. But seeing them again after looking through the Genocide Jack file, something's not quite right. Yeah, she wasn't stabbed multiple times and then strung up with scissors. Which, look at that one. Dude, those scissors are stabbed through the dude's hands into freaking concrete. Whoever Genocide Jack is, real badass. Not gonna lie. What does this all mean? Status of the dead body's been added. Okay, well, the one thing most likely to tie all these mysteries together is the true nature of the rope that was used to suspend Chihiro. And to figure that out, there's a certain place I need to revisit to look over. You don't have to do it. Has a plug on it. It's an extension cord. It's not a rope. Well, to look at the Genocide Jack case file one more time. Ugh. Alright. Should have had Sakura check the body. Like... excuse me. Oh, excuse me again. Anyways, should have just had Sakura. I mean, if you feel that uncomfortable, you should just be like, hey, Sakura, can you look at the body for me? Will you let me know if Chihiro's a guy or a girl? That way it'll, clear some things up for me. Alright, yeah, see, it's not... don't look at the damn desk, dude, look... Alright, we're gonna go back here. Alright, let's see, was it here? The wooden box is empty, the extension cord was in there before. The desk lamp. Byakuya grabbed that one thing from over here and put it over there. Sure is dark over there. That doesn't even make sense. Alright, so is there something... okay, it's not back there. Nope, okay. Alright, so we're gonna look at the Genocide Jack case file... we were. Someone take it out of the archive. But the only one who would do something like that... I can't think of anyone but Byakuya. Yeah, that's true. It would be... well, unless Genocide Jack knew that we were... unless... if Genocide Jack is in here and they knew that we're on the trail... then they might... can I look at that? Nope. No, not there. The lamp won't turn on. Oh, I see, it's not plugged in. The lamp's cord isn't long enough to reach the outlet. It was definitely on, it was definitely right here. Byakuya was using an extension cord, which was the same freaking extension cord that was used to tie up Chihiro. Alright, so we got the library desk lamp. Alright. Alright, I guess... so we're missing the Genocide Jack case file. And we're missing the extension cord because poor Chihiro was strung up using it. That's horrible. That really is. Oh. Sup, Taka? I have to go see... annoying girl herself. I thought it was right here. Well, she's not annoying. I actually kind of like Celeste. She's a little freaky, but what can I say? It's the hair. The hair just gets me. And Celeste was in here, and she is here. Awesome. Sup, Celeste? What are you doing here? More importantly, why did you seem to want to talk to me, or what kind of clue did you find? And why are you way cheerful? This warehouse is amazing. It has absolutely everything one might need to live a full life. From food to clothes to towels, there's an endless supply to choose from.
I see that, but have you found anything related to the case?
And her accent. I love that accent. It's just got that slightest hint of German flair to it. I knew you were going to ask me that. I thought talking about the warehouse itself might misdirect you, but I see it was pointless.
Then you did find some...
Very well, I will tell you, and only you. Last night, I saw her here. Chihiro was in the warehouse.
Really?
This was right before nighttime.
Ooh. Yeah, what are you doing out this late, Chihiro? And another question kind of comes to mind here. How much hair gel or hairspray do you think Celeste needs to have her hair stay like that, like, all day? Maybe she uses, I don't know. Sorry, getting sidetracked again, guys. My bad. It's really late here and I'm kind of tired.
Oh, I was just... Are you planning to go exercise, perhaps? What? How did you know?
Well, you look like you're holding a bag, and it looks like it's got a, I don't know, long-sleeve shirt or, like, a windbreaker jacket or something in there.
Because I can see a blue track jacket sticking out of that duffel bag you're carrying. Oh, you're right. Thanks.
Alright, so we see a blue track jacket.
Well, I'd better get going. I'm kind of in a hurry.
Very strange. Very strange indeed.
She stuffed the jacket into her bag in a hurry. It was almost like she was trying to hide it.
So she didn't want anyone to know? Well, Sakura and Hina always invited her to work out. So...
And just like that, she was gone. I assumed she was merely stocking up to go exercise in the morning, but it would appear she ignored the nighttime rule and headed directly to the girls' locker room. If she hadn't broken our rule, none of this ever would have happened. You get what you deserve, I suppose.
Oh, come on, don't be like that. That's just mean. I mean, on the one hand, I get where the nighttime rule comes from, but for crying out loud. You go out at night, you die. That's like some bad B-horror movie. Well, apparently, she went to the girls' locker room late at night in order to exercise without anyone knowing. But the strange thing is, there was no trace of the track jacket or duffel bag Celeste said she saw Chihiro carrying. Which would mean the killer would have gotten rid of it somehow. Curiouser and curiouser. Alright, well, Celeste, nice talking to you. Appreciate it. Is that protein coffee that frickin' Sakura goes on about? No. Of course not. That's one thing I would like about this game, is if it was a little more interactive. Alright, so what am I missing? I'm probably missing a few. No, actually, I don't see any 13, 14, 15 of 15, so aren't I done? Or pretty nearly done? What could be left? Maybe I gotta check, I don't know. All that comes to mind is maybe I gotta check the body or something. What's up, Taka? Maybe we should have confessed our embarrassing secrets after all. Damn it. I'm sorry, Chihiro. It's all because I wasn't strong enough.
Aw, don't blame yourself, Taka. I'm pretty sure you would have known you would have tried to help her. Or been there for her. So, don't freaking blame yourself, dude. You're alright. Although, we still have to figure out that one... I don't know. I need to figure out... Do I need to check on... Did I pass it? Yeah, I passed it. Of course I did. Alright. So what's left? I mean, I checked on the girls' locker room, and I checked on the Genocide Jack file thing. Maybe... I don't know. Chihiro's hands are bound with what looks like some kind of rope. It isn't rope.
Fatal injury was a blow to the head, struck in the head, that's right. Then we saw something's not quite right. What does it all mean? The rope. Hey, what? I wish they would tell me what frickin' certain place I need to go, because I don't frickin' know. One bad thing about this game, it does not... Like, at some points, it takes you by the hand and doesn't let you frickin' go. So you have to do everything that the game tells you to do. And at other points, like right now, I think I need to go in here and have a look around. But it's not showing me anything I haven't already seen before. So... I don't know. Alright, so we'll try and take this in steps. But where did it go? Did Byakuya maybe take it and what? Oh, don't tell me, do not tell me Byakuya killed Chihiro. I mean, as sad as I am that Chihiro's gone, if I could make it Byakuya's fault and get rid of him, oh, that'd be great. Oh, that would be like the best of all. The extension cord was in there before. Yeah, I freaking know. It's a desk lamp, and he grabbed it, and it's dark over there, and it's dark over here, and so where the heck am I supposed to go? All right, so there's nothing there, nothing there. Maybe... I'm all sorts of confused now. Where the heck am I supposed to go? What am I... The game is not telling me. I really wish I could force Monokuma to just call the frickin' bell so that way I can be done looking at stuff I've already looked at 100 times. Alright, where could Byakuya have gone? I'm a little curious. I don't think he'd be in the classroom. I think I'm going to look around here so I don't waste you guys' time. I'm going to look around real quick. If I come across something, we'll just cut in there. And we'll take it from there. So we'll be back in a few minutes, guys. Well, guys, after much looking around and not finding a single damn thing to help me out, we haven't spoken to Aoi yet. So I think, if I remember right, Aoi is... Let's see, that's the entrance hall. Aoi should be in the dining hall, I think. But I think we have to talk to her... Hope we have to talk to her, because she's the only other person I can think of. And hopefully then we can move this investigation slash murder trial thing along. Hey, Hina, how's Toko doing?
Same as before, she won't come out. She just keeps on mumbling something about Genocide Jack. So I just left her there.
Wow. You left her?
My head was all swimmy and I was getting pretty hungry.
Oh, so you came here for some donuts, didn't you?
Oh, but don't worry. I'm gonna head back as soon as I'm done eating. Toko's not exactly pleasant, but I'm still worried about her.
Speaking of which, what are you eating?
A donut, of course.
Figures. Of course?
There are two things I'm sure God created. Outer space and donuts.
I have no idea what those two have to do with each other, but whatever. Really.
I bet Chihiro would have liked to eat more donuts. Maybe that was her one big regret. I should have tried to spend more time with her.
Come to think of it, who did she spend time with? Well, she spent time with me.
Yeah, she was a bit strange. I didn't really hang out with the other girls much. It was like she was trying to keep her distance from us.
Actually, Sakura said something similar. She said that even though you and her invited Chihiro to exercise with you, she always refused.
Yep, it's true, but it wasn't just us either. It was like she stayed away from all the girls.
Was she just shy?
I don't know. She talked to the boys all the time.
Isn't it kind of weird? That's that's Hina talking still. My bad.
Isn't it kind of weird to be shy around your own sex, but totally fine with the opposite sex? Oh, wait. Maybe she was used to guys spoiling her. The law says you can't judge a book by its cover, right?
I wish the law said that. That would be great. I think so. I never really saw her as that kind of girl. Always count. Hey, finally! We get to move along. Dear God.
I'm getting tired of waiting. Shall we just plunge right in?
Sounds good to me.
It's the moment you've all been waiting for! The class trial! You remember where to meet, right? Please go through the red door on the first floor of the school. See you soon.
All right. Excuse me.
Begin the class trial, or it's about to begin.
Yep.
The red door.
All right. I think I have all the evidence I need. I just hope I can use it properly.
So is everyone ready or what?
Am I blind or are we missing someone?
No.
Yeah, Toko's not here.
And Toko is...
You really don't remember?
Come on. I'm kidding. How could I forget about that little nut job? She's a crucial part of the class trial this time.
Wait, what?
Okie dokie, I'll go ahead and drag her out here, kicking and screaming. Just one moment, please.
And just like he said a few minutes later, he reappeared, dragging Toko behind him. That would be kind of awkward for this little tiny bear to be dragging people along, isn't it?
Alright, calm the frick down, woman. Jeez. Holy crap. Don't freak out. It's alright. I told him I didn't want to, but he forced me. I can't believe you would drag a girl around.
I can't. It's Monokuma.
You're terrible. So now everyone's here, right? Okay, then let's hustle on to the elevator and let's get the show on the road. I'll see you guys down there.
Let's go. Oh boy, shall we get going? It's time to find out who killed Chihiro. Not really looking forward to this class trial. Chihiro Fujisaki. She was so gentle, so calm and meek. Nobody had any problem with her. And yet, someone made the choice to kill a girl like that. I know, right? Jeez. And the murderer is one of us. Someone standing right here. Just to let you all know, I don't trust any of you. Not a single one. Now let's get on the frickin' elevator. We have no choice, right? We have to do this. Yes. I gave a small nod in reply. With one last deep breath, I walked towards the elevator on shaky legs. With each step forward, I could feel my heart starting to race faster and faster. As soon as everyone was on, the elevator began to descend. I couldn't get a handle on my emotions. Couldn't stop speculating. Oh, man. Steel box sank with heavy clunking sounds deeper and deeper into the ground. And as we went deeper, the uneasiness in my heart grew bigger and bigger. The elevator was unaffected, however, and continued to descend without hesitation.
until finally it came to a sudden stop. Oh man,
what do you think? I've decorated. Isn't it so fresh? Isn't it so exciting?
Right? Don't waste our time with stupid questions. Let's get this over with. Yeah, no matter how nice of a paint job you put on the place, it's still kind of freaky.
Good, you're rip-roaring to go. Gotta say, I don't hate it. Not at all. Okay, then. Let's get this show on the road. Everyone find your assigned seats.
Oh, yay. And so the curtain opened once again. A deadly judgment, a deadly deception, a deadly betrayal. A deadly riddle, a deadly... Oh, boy. Jeez. So many deadly things. Yes, a deadly class trial. You want to save the data? Yes. Right there. All right. Let's do some prep work, shall we?